them. I got so many of these. Hey guys, welcome back to DIY in 5. I'm Trisha Hershberger, and today we're going to show you 5 more tips to speed up your Windows 10 machine. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe so you can see all our other upcoming Windows tips.
I just can't do it, Captain. I don't have the power.
Have we really not made that joke yet? Changing your power settings to max performance is pretty much a one-button solution for getting some more juice out of your system. This is probably not the best choice if you're concerned with sipping electricity, but it will definitely boost your performance. Go to Control Panel, System, and Security, Power Options. Click on the drop-down arrow on the right side and choose High Performance. Next, we have to uninstall Crapware. No, that's not the technical name for it, and yes, I stand by it anyway. Even after all these years, manufacturers still do it. They add unnecessary software that continues to be an issue for new computers.
Are you kidding me? I just bought this thing.
But the good news is it's easy to remove. Click on the Start button, then on All Apps at the bottom, and right-click on the offender and choose Uninstall. This will immediately uninstall that nasty bugger. You could also right-click on the Windows logo Start button and choose the top choice Programs and Features. Either way you go, it's gone for good. Okay, now it's time to turn off search indexing. One of the ways Windows 10 has tried to improve search results is by indexing files on your system. This can be a handy tool if you have lots of miscellaneous files that might be scattered about and accessed at various times. But search indexing can eat up system resources. So if you want every last drop of speed from your CPU, turning it off is a good option. If you're constantly wondering, where's that one file? This probably isn't a good solution, as it does really quickly find things.
Where the hell did I put that?
To update your settings, type index in the search box and select indexing options. Click modify and remove locations being indexed and also file types. This next one's a bummer, but it'll get the job done. It seems that every time there's an OS upgrade, it looks newer and flashier than past versions. And that's because it is flashier, but at a cost. Windows 10 has a few new features like shadows, animations, and visual effects. On faster and newer PCs, you won't see much difference, but on slower and older PCs, this might take a hit. To toggle your settings, type Adjust Appearance in the search box and select Adjust for Best Performance. Or, if you want to customize it, you can select which features you want to keep. One of those last-ditch efforts for bringing your system back to life is to do a fresh install. If you've ever been plagued by malware, adware, or just can't figure out why your system is so sluggish, this is a great last resort. Of course, whenever you do a system install, make sure you back up your files. I can't emphasize that enough.
No!
If done properly, your system will feel brand new again with no reports, photo, or PDFs in sight. So how old is your system? Let us know in the comments below. This one is 5 years old now and still kicking. Fingers crossed. If these fixes injected some new life into your PC and you're craving more, check out this video for even more tips to speed up your Windows 10 PC. Until next time, I'm Trisha Hershberger and thanks for watching.